Despite the immediate concerns of supply, the county is confident it will expand to the next tier for vaccinations the first week of March. That includes teachers, food and agricultural workers, and law enforcement. Then on March the 15th, people ages 16 to 64 with certain health conditions will also be eligible. Our ABC 10 News reporter Mimi Alcala takes an in-depth look at how the county is preparing for these rapid changes.
People my age that have underlying health conditions, most of them are still working.
According to the California Department of Public Health, starting March 15th, healthcare providers will be able to offer the COVID-19 vaccine to people between the ages of 16 and 64 with serious and specific underlying health conditions, including cancer, chronic kidney disease that's stage 4 or above, chronic pulmonary disease must be oxygen dependent, Down syndrome, immunocompromised state from solid organ transplant, pregnancy, sickle cell disease, certain heart conditions such as heart failure but excluding hypertension, severe obesity, and type 2 diabetes. People with developmental or other severe high-risk disabilities may also be qualified. But is San Diego County prepared for this next group?
I think the plan is, March 15th, that we would, it's all dependent upon supply of vaccines in terms of how many appointments are there. But I think that there is a great value in adding.
Supervisor Nathan Fletcher says March 1st, the county plans to be able to open vaccinations to the first group of essential workers like teachers and police officers. Then by March 15th, people with qualifying medical conditions listed by the state can go next. Fletcher did say it would be easier for people to go through their health care providers who have access to their medical records, but those who don't have a provider can go through a county site.
I want to stick around for a while.
Lauren Gillihan isn't currently eligible to get a COVID-19 vaccine. She's been worried, locked down at home for nearly a year. And unfortunately, seeing the list of qualified health conditions didn't provide much comfort as her condition was left out.
I have lupus and something called antiphospholipid syndrome. It could be deadly for me if I get COVID.
Her husband has type 2 diabetes, so he may be qualified come March 15th.
How quickly you move through all those is dependent upon the supply.
The California Department of Public Health tells me it's continuing to work with the federal government to increase the state's vaccine supply, but ultimately there are limits to how much vaccine can be manufactured at this point. A spokesperson for Kaiser says while the state's expansion to this next group makes sense, without a significant increase in the vaccine supply from the federal government, it could take months to vaccinate this new population.
I want to hug my kids and see my kids and live life again.
Mimi Alcala, ABC 10 News.
Both Sharp and Palomar Health said that they are awaiting county guidance for this next group. We did not immediately hear back from Scripps Health. As of today, more than 473,000 people in San Diego County have been vaccinated for COVID-19. More than 135,000 have been fully vaccinated, meaning 5% of the local population has received both shots. And we know that there are still a lot of questions and different experiences with the vaccine rollout. Our ABC 10 News in-depth team is committed to tracking down answers and sharing your stories. So just send us an email to tips@10news.com.